around 50 drivers, 3 categories and 1 championship trophy. As we get set to crown the national karting champions across 3 categories, let's take you back to the euphoria that can only come from the open-wheeled bumper-to-bumper racing that these young drivers have showcased over the entire season of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship.
Physically and mentally, it is quite challenging.
I don't think any other sport offers you that much adrenaline rush at a particular weekend, so it's amazing.
Hey, we're racing drivers. If you see a small gap, you go in. Because if you no longer go for a gap that exists, you're no longer a racing driver.
Behind me is the V1 karting circuit in Visakhapatnam and the heats for the final round of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship are underway in full swing. The championships are relatively wide open and the drivers are trying their best to outdo one another. But by the end of this weekend, only one of them shall have the bragging rights to be called National Karting Champion. Let's see how the weekend pans out. Roll clip! The championship is in its 11th consecutive year and is based on the regulations of the Rotax Max Challenge. Rotax is the largest kart engine manufacturer in the world. And as we head into the grand finale, let's take a look into the driver standings across categories and break down the points tally. First up is the Micro Max category. Meco Racing's Yash Aradhya leads this category with 154 points in the bag. A tough nut to overtake, Aradhya's determination to take the flag ahead of the field is something that drives his kart as much as him. Behind him is his Meco Racing teammate Paul Francis. Slight of build but not short in determination in any manner, Francis's skill behind the kart steering is a treat to watch. Francis has 140 points in his bag and that means that he's still a threat that can't be written off.
It's a good chance for me this year. Hopefully I make use of it and I think I can win it.
It would be nice to win the race as a nice season ender, but so second place still is very good. I'd like to go for the win. This is my last year in Micro Max. Next year I will be joining the Junior Max category.
So my first target is to win the race and come on the second slot in the championship. But it's not easy because they are good drivers like Yash and Paul. And the track is very bumpy and it's difficult to maintain the lead.
The Junior Max category is next in line, with the competition being the most closely contested. BPC Racing's Ricky Donison leads with 144 points. It's only Donison's second year in karting, and the talented driver has made heads turn with his brilliant racing all through the season. Close behind him is Dark Dawn Racing's World Karting Championship driver, Kush Maini. Maini's staggering experience behind the go-kart wheel is something that makes him formidable. Both drivers, though, are evenly matched. and this one will go down to the checkered flag for sure.
I'm going to need to concentrate a lot and just put my focus onto the race. Obviously, my aim is to win the pre-final and the final. And if I do that, I think I'll be champion. And I'm planning to do that. We're showing really good pace here and really fast. And just last race, I was leading the championship by 14 points. But in racing, anything happens. And I just threw it away in one race. And so now I'm a little bit lagging behind in the championship.
Last year was my first year in karting, and I really hope that, you know, I wasn't expecting to win the championship my second year. So then I went in wanting to get like into the top three. I didn't know I'd come so far. And you know, there were problems in the first round, but you know, that happens in racing. And you know, I'm really happy to be leading the championship right now.
The Senior Max category is where the heat is at its best. All through the seasons, the top drivers have been separated by just 1/10 of a second. Former national champion Amir Bafna of Rio Racing leads the championship with 147 points. Defending national karting champ Vishnu Prasad of Meko Racing is running second with 133 points in the bag. And breathing down his neck, tied at 130 points, is the combined aggression of Mohite's Racing Academy drivers, Chitesh Mandodi and Dhruv Mohite. There's going to be some hard racing, and that's always a lot of fun.
I'm under pressure, obviously, but I have to keep my cool. Luckily, I have a slightly healthy margin. I'm leading by 14 points, which is a healthy margin in the last round. Hopefully, I can keep it together and finish on top.
The points difference is a little big, but you know, it's racing. I think you should never give up until the end. Definitely going to keep pushing this weekend for the win, and hopefully, you know, things will work out and I can win the championship at the end of the day.
The pre-final races not only count for points in the championship, they also lock the starting grid positions for the final race. And so, when the pit lanes opened for the pre-final races, drivers across categories took to the tarmac as if they had long-standing grudges against their tyres. In the Micromax category, Yash Aradhya pulled off a brilliant win to consolidate his lead in the class championship. Arun Nair drove a great race to clinch second, and BPC Racing's find of the 2014 season, Chirag Ghorpade, was third. Things heated up as expected in the Junior Max pre-final, immediately after the green flag was waved at the rolling start, and the drivers hit the first corner. As Donison held his line on his way out of C1, many came towards the outer, causing Donison to climb over his cart and almost spin out. Ravindra lunged out of the gap that Manny had left and took the lead. Donison recovered and was hot on his tail with Gowda in tow. And while that was happening, Manny spun and had to settle for fourth. Donison outpaced Ravindra and overtook him to take the race win. Gowda came in third.
Everybody clap your hands in the air, bring it up for Ricky Donison from Team BBC Racing. Aro Ravindra comes in at number 2 from Team Rio. Akash Gowda comes in at 3.
Chitesh Mandodi dominated most of the Senior Max pre-final race before Dhruv Mohite overtook him towards the end to clinch the checkered flag. Playing it safe and keeping a cool head behind them, Bafna came in a comfortable third. Coming up on JK Tyre Racing Lines, all the action from the grand finale of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship.
After the madness of the heats in the pre-final races, it is now time for the finals of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship. Over to the races. Micromax category sees the hardest fights, and that's how the season has panned out for frontrunners Yash Aradhya, Shahan Ali and Paul Francis. As the Micromax drivers take to the tarmac, stay tuned for some bumper-to-bumper racing.
We've got to wait for the green flag. This is it. This is what we waited for. In the Indian finals, all those turn green, and they're going to be fighting it out on the corner number one. Chirag moves in very strong as well. What a way to do that. Chirag moves into number two as well. In fact, side by side, Chirag goes down on number two and three. They're moving down very strong as well. This is a good start. Yes, he's now getting a little bit run for his money from Chirag. Chirag has come out like a little bit of a surprise on fire climbing. And they're moving down as well. This was a little bit unexpected. Yash is already facing the heat from competition number 9. In fact, Arjun Nair will just fall back and just listen to it. Paul Francis takes the number 3 right now. Arjun Nair now at number 4. Shahan, who started the race at 6, moves to number 5. What a drive by him already so far. Are we going to expect any competitions? Opening lap, already so much drama. Can we expect anything more? That's what we're going to be looking at. Chirag now trying to line up.
As the Micromax drivers took to the tarmac, Meco Racing's Aradhya ran away right after the green flag came out and had an untroubled run thereafter. Behind him though, the fight was on. BBC Racing's Chirag Ghorpade and Meco Racing's Paul Francis exchanged places multiple times and were bumper to bumper throughout the race. In the end, as Aradhya took the checkered flag and the championship win, Ghorpade came in second and Francis settled for third.
Finals was an amazing race. I started first, I was leading and I could feel the pressure behind me. That's Chirag, he was bumping me a lot. I felt the pressure and then I'm like, okay, no more playing safe, come on, let's go harder. And then I pushed as hard as I can and I built up a gap, and last two laps, again, he was right behind me, and last lap, I just got the quickest lap time.
Coming into Vizag, I was really hoping to get the win and trying to go all out, but Yash was just really quick. He's a very good champion, a very good driver, one I respect. It was a very hard race and I got third, second in the championship. It's been a good weekend and I'm happy with what I have.
It's a good thing coming on the top three with a DQ. And I'm very happy to be on the podium. It was a very less difference between the fourth guy. It was only 1 point, and Chirag also drove very well. It could have been a tie if he could have gained a position.
Ricky Donison of BPC Racing leads the Junior Max Championship by only 4 points. And behind him is the fire-breathing experience of World Karting Championship driver Kush Maini. This one is all set to go down to the wire. Let's see how the race pans out.
It's the green flag. Corner number one comes up. Ricky Donison runs away. In fact, it's competition number 36. Mira's giving a little bit of push for the fight for the fourth and the fifth. Kush already up to number three. So it looks like our competition number 33 is going to really face the heat. That is Akash Goda is at number two. Kush made some.
And down to the wire it went. Donison started on pole and was quick off the line and held his lead. Maini, who started fourth, drove with the class of a world championship driver and was steadily making his way up. Maini effortlessly overtook Gowda and Ravindra and slotted himself behind Donison, who was now feeling the pressure. And then the fight began. Maini and Donison went bumper to bumper and changed places several times. But in the end, Maini made a stellar move to take the lead and made it stick to take the checkered flag. Donison settled for second place and Ravindra came in third. Donison was provisionally awarded the championship title as a protest made by many after the pre-final race was under consideration by the FMSCI.
Pre-final, I had a bit of contact in the start which made me go back to 11th, and I fought back to 4th and I couldn't do more because there was too big of a gap. And then in the final I started 4th, and my dad said winners always win on the track and not in the office. And I went out and I did my best shot, and I think my dad's really proud of me because I won from 4th. Every lap I got everyone on the same corner, which is C3. Every time I just dived in there and really quick. And I got the maximum number of pole positions, which is 5 pole positions and 5 fastest laps. So we've definitely proved that we're the fastest on the track. But to win a championship, you need to have luck and the fastest lap. and definitely the luck wasn't there in this time.
I started first. I was feeling lots of pressure from Kush behind me. I didn't know when he was going to come behind me, but I managed to sort of, you know, stick with second place and finish the race because I didn't want to, you know, fight too much for the battle and push too hard and you mess up my race. So I sat behind in second and just finished the race. I wasn't expecting to win the championship this year, but we've had good luck. We've had a few good races and, you know, I'm happy that I'm here. And I'm really happy to be holding the trophy right now.
Congratulations, Kush. Very well done indeed. We just...
The senior max category drivers are the cowboys of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship. The competition in the category is so close that the front runners are separated by only 1/10 of a second. As championship leader Amir Bafna takes to the tarmac this weekend, he knows full well that he's being chased down by the combined driving prowess of the likes of Vishnu Prasad, Chitesh Mandodi and Dhruv Mohite. And that, if you ask me, is a daunting predicament. Over to the race.
As always, it's so crucial. Will the green flag come out? At the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max Karting Champ 2014, which is a hope. Coming out. Chitesh, on the move. It's Dhruv Mohite already drops back up. And... Dhruv Mohite drops back up. Amir Bafna is still at number 4.
Dhruv Mohite started on pole for the Senior Max final, but he succumbed to pressure from his teammate Chitesh Mandodi and gave up his lead. Rayo Racing's Nayan Chatterjee was running third, and he mounted the pressure on Mohite and eventually overtook him. Mohite tried hard to take back his place, but Chatterjee managed to hold him off and finish second behind Mandodi. Rayo Racing's Amir Bafna had kept his wits about him and observed the action from afar. He crossed the checkered flag fourth and jumped to 181 points. Enough to bag the championship. As Bafna races under the Indian colours at the World Final in Spain this weekend, we wish him all the luck.
Before for this round, I had planned to finish second in the championship and it feels great like after you doing it. And my teammate Dhruv Mohite, he is third, which makes me more happy. So it's good feeling. Nothing more I can ask for. Like.
So starting first, I let Chitesh go as he had the pace. We planned following him and everyone wanted to play safe, but Nayan had it. And even at 15 laps, I was a little faster than him. There's no point taking a risk because I knew I had the championship.
I was extremely nervous because I've been in those positions once before and it wasn't easy, I can tell you that. Like, you know, Vishnu is driving since 13 years, multiple-time national champion. Chitesh, multiple-time national champion. We have good drivers like Nikhil Kashyap, who's also a multiple-time national champion, Nayan Chatterjee and whatnot, you know, Dhruv Mohite and Krishna, but he was unfortunately not there for this round because he was ill. But yeah, it's always tense, it's always going to be hard. You have to keep your calm and be composed. But yeah, it feels really nice to be champion for the second time. I think on today's grid, I'm the only driver to have two national championships. So I'm really happy about that.
And I think it was one of the most satisfying experiences this year because we got the Kolhapur track back and running. So that was the high point. We have now two tracks different locations in Hyderabad. So all the five rounds happen in five different locations. And having said so, let's not forget the competition levels of Ricky and Kush. I think they entertained the crowds by far like nobody expected what we saw. And it was incredible the way the entire competition went down the wire. Let's not forget, they both are already doing well internationally. And there is a lot to learn for everyone on that gate from these two boys. But if somebody asks me, what do I do this event for? It's for the micros. And I'm sure I don't have to name the kids, but Yash was a phenomena. This little kid from Agra is amazing. And the man who takes the cake is Paul. And because I remember seeing one of the interviews on your channel itself, the way he says that it's insane driving there.
So imagine an 8-year-old in that frame of mind. So it's totally a different experience. I think it was one of the finest seasons, if I may go back in history, that went by. And if things go well and the kind of setup that we have, I'm sure that there would be at least 40% of this grid who would be going international very, very soon in their own spheres.
And that brings us to the end of the 11th JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship. As the stellar season comes to a close, we leave you with some high points from all the 5 rounds. Next week on JK Tyre Racing Lines, all the high-octane racing action from the second round of the JK Tyre Racing Championship.